All right, picking up where we left off in the last video there. I think I got my coffin under control now. We'll see. So now we're going to have to substitute in these two x values that we found into one of our equations. And again, I just chose the first equation. I don't know, just because. So wherever we see an x, we're going to start by substituting in this negative 2.45. Okay, so we get y equals 3 times negative 2.45 squared plus 5 times negative 2.45 minus 6. Okay, so since we do have the calculators handy, I am going to use my calculator just because I can. So again, I'm going to put in 2.45 and square it. And I get 6.0025. And then I'm going to multiply that by 3. And I get 18.0075. Okay, now typically you're not going to round it, but you know, we can work with these numbers since we're using the calculator. Now I'm going to do 5 times negative 2.45. And I get negative 12.25. Okay, so 18.0075 minus 12.25 minus 6 gives me y equals negative 0.24. Okay, and we can round it to that, that's fine. So our first point of intersection is going to be where x is negative 2.45 and y is negative 0.24-ish. Okay, so there's our first point of intersection for our two quadratics. Now let's do for our second x value, which is that 0.65. So again, I'm going to use the same equation, that 3x squared plus 5x minus 6, and this time just substitute in 0.65. So I have y equals 3 times 0.65 squared plus 5 times 0.65 minus 6. Okay, so again, use the handy dandy calculator. 0.65 squared is going to be 0.4225. Multiply that by 3. You get 1.2675. Okay. And then 5 times 0.65. And you get 3.25 minus 6. All right. And so now let's just finish this up. So 1.2675 plus 3.25 minus 6 equals negative 1.4825. Okay, again, we can round that to two decimal places. So our second point of intersection should be at 0.65 comma negative 1.48-ish. Okay, so again, we want to check this in our graphing calculator. It's always good to get a graph and a visual. So remember to substitute in your two equations here for your y1 and your y2. Make sure you type everything in correctly. And just for the sake of being able to see and distinguish between the two equations, I made the line of the second equation a bit darker and wider than the first one, just so you can see it when we graph it. So now we press graph, and you can see what our two quadratics look like on the graph. And when we check those points of intersection, let's do a trace. And let's go where x is, well, since we're close, let's do x is 0.65. And so about right there, tracing is going to be about as close as we can get. And you can see that the y is negative 1.5. So that's pretty doggone close to what we got. So I think our answer is pretty accurate. And then if we go over to negative, where x is negative 2.45, And I think that's about as close as we're going to get. You can see that. Yeah, it's just going to jump there. You can see that we're pretty close there to that 0 point. Negative 0.24. No. It's pretty close there. It's like in between those two values. So maybe if we zoomed in, but I feel pretty confident with our answer. Okay. Very confident, actually. Let me reword that. I feel very confident about our answer. We could also look at the table if we wanted to really dig deep in there to make sure we were right. Okay. So good luck on working these problems out.